وهل أتاك حديث موسى إذ رأى نارا فقال لأهلهم كثوا إني آنست نارا لعلي آتيكم منها بقبس أو أجد على النار هدى.
بسم الله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم وبعد. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إذ تمشي أختك فتقول هل أدلكم على من يكفله فرجعناك إلى أمك كي تقر عينها ولا تحزن وقتلت نفسا فنجيناك من الغم وفتناك فتونا فلبثت سنين في أهل مدين ثم جئت على قدري يا موسى. صدق الله العظيم. So that is the 40th verse of Surah Taha. In the previous segment, we concluded at the point where this baby Musa alayhi salatu wasalam, arrived at the palace, and there was much hype, there was much excitement, there was much curiosity, and of course everyone was just blown away by his beauty and the nur that had enveloped Sayyidina Musa alayhi salatu wasalam. And in this way he kind of made himself into the palace as a baby. عَلَى رَغْمِ فِرْعَوْنِ وَجُنُودِ. Despite Pharaoh and his plotting and his killing, etc. Now the next development that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about in the verse that we just recited, and we will reference it with the book that we're reading along to create the story format of the entire tale and narrative, is the aspect of the nursing and the suckling of Sayyidina Musa alayhi salatu wasalam. So the question is, مَنْ يُرْضِعُ الطِّفْلَ. مَنْ يُرْضِعُ الطِّفْلَ. We're going to, you know, take the verse of the Quran and match it with this explanation, and the two just tie up in absolute harmony, as it's a commentary of the verses of the Quran. مَنْ يُرْضِعُ الطِّفْلَ. Who is going to nurse the child? Who is going to nurse this baby? كَانَ الطِّفْلُ الْجَدِيدُ وَكَانَ الطِّفْلُ الْجَمِيلُ لُعْبَةَ الْقَصْرِ وَلَهْوَ الدَّارِ. So this boy that had arrived, this baby that had arrived, he was just an attraction. He was the talk of the palace. And because it was now in the royal family, so news filters down across Egypt and everybody is talking about it. Something happens in the royal family, the media run with it, the paper run with it, and then it's on social media and it's a talk for everyone. كُلٌّ يَأْخُذُهُ وَيُقَبِّلُهُ وَكُلٌّ يُحِبُّهُ وَيَمْدَحُهُ. Every second person, you've seen the baby, yeah, I believe the queen has adopted it, absolutely. And everybody just loves him, he's so sweet, he's so adorable, he's so loving, etc. لِأَنَّ الْمَلِكَةَ تُحِبُّهُ حُبًّا عَظِيمًا. Because the queen, Asiya bint Muzahim, she loved him, and this was in the overall plan of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that this child was to grow up and benefit this woman, as she had mentioned, عَسَىٰ أَن يَنْفَعَنَا. فَكَيْفَ لَا تُحِبُّهُ سَيِّدَاتُ الْقَصْرِ وَكَيْفَ لَا يُحِبُّهُ خَدَمُ الْقَصْرِ. When the queen loves him, well, then everybody wants to up their position in the eyes of the queen. So love what the queen loves, despise what the queen despises, agree with them and just tag along and follow on. وَطَلَبَتِ الْمَلِكَةُ مُرْضِعًا تُرْضِعُ الطِّفْلَ. So the queen then decided that let's get a wet nurse, let's get someone to nurse and suckle this child. It's a baby, it's 3 months old. Now we need to attend to the child and we need to see the child needs to be nursed. So وجاءت وأخذت الطفل ولكن الطفل يبكي ويأبى. The first nurse was called in, and again, from the perspective of these nurses, each one of them was hopeful that they would be the woman who could nurse this child, simply because now you are nursing a royal member, and this will generate some handsome revenue for you. This will generate some handsome revenue for you. And my mind just runs back to the blessed seerah of our Habib sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that when the woman came from the outskirts and they came to come and pick up children in the hope of taking them with generating revenue. Halima Sa'diyya radiallahu anha herself said that initially I was skeptical simply because I was told this was an orphan. So there wasn't anything promising in terms of material return. So initially I said no, but soon I realized everyone from my tribe had found a baby, embraced a baby, and started nursing a baby. And I said to my husband, well, the only child left behind was Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, so let's just take him up. And Halima Sa'diyya radiallahu anha says, I barely latched him on, and my destiny and my fate changed instantly. From my camel brimming with milk, from my conveyance becoming swift, from barakah and blessings enveloping me in every regard. وَطَلَبَتِ الْمَلِكَةُ مُرْضِعًا أُخْرَى وَحَضَرَتْ وَأَخَذَتِ الطِّفْلَ وَلَكِنَّ الطِّفْلَ يَبْكِي وَيَأْبَى. So then the queen said, probably this woman doesn't have the best of milk, she doesn't know how to latch, she doesn't know how to nurse, let's call for someone else. Money was not an issue, contact was not an issue, pain was not an issue, because it's now part of the royal family. So summon this one, request this one, second, third, fourth. عَجَبًا لِمَاذَا لَا يَرْضَعُ الطِّفْلَ لِأَيِّ شَيْءٍ يَبْكِي. But now days are moving on, literally days. Day one goes, day two goes, and this child is simply not drinking anything. اجْتَهَدَتِ الْمَرَاضِعُ أَن تُرْضِعَ الطِّفْلَ. Every nurse tried her level best, coming with absolute charm, love, affection, warmness, tenderness, gentleness. Why? لِتَنَالَ مِنْهَا جَائِزَ. So that she can receive a handsome gift. She can receive a handsome gift from the queen. وَلَكِنَّ اللَّهَ حَرَّمَ عَلَيْهِ الْمَرَاضِعِ. But as the verse of the 20th juz, Surah Qasas, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَحَرَّمْنَا عَلَيْهِ الْمَرَاضِعَ مِنْ قَبْلُ فَقَالَتْ هَلْ أَدُلُّكُمْ عَلَىٰ أَهْلِ بَيْتِ. And we had barred all nurses on you, O Musa. We had barred you. It wasn't, we had made it such that you were not to drink or be nursed by any other woman. حَرَّمْنَا عَلَيْهِ الْمَرَاضِعِ مِنْ قَبْلِ. So now the panic and the anxiety is creating great amount of uneasiness in the palace, that if this pattern persists, this child is going to wither away. This child is going to wither away. So in this confusion, in this uncertainty, first nurse, second, third, fourth, fifth, but the child blatantly refuses, just refuses. He would not latch onto any woman. أَصْبَحَ الطِّفْلُ حَدِيثَ الْقَصْرِ وَشُغْلَ الدَّارِ. So from happiness and joy, it now goes to a bit of a somber mode, sadness, panic, fear, uncertainty, where to from now. The child is so sweet, he's so adorable, he's so lovable. But hang on, you know what, he's just crying and crying and crying, and we don't know what to do. وَلَكِنَّهُ طِفْلٌ غَرِيبٌ لَيْسَ كَالْأَطْفَالِ إِنَّهُ لَا يَرْتَضِعْ وَإِذَا أَخَذَتْهُ مُرْضِعٌ يَبْكِي وَيَأْبَى. كَيْفَ يَعِيشْ إِنَّهُ سَيَمُوتْ. The panic is getting louder, that if this continues, then the death of this child is going to become more imminent and louder and more certain. And now we tie up with the verse of the Quran, as Allah told Sayyidina Musa alayhi salam, to recap, my respected brother listener, is that Sayyidina Musa alayhi salam has been tasked by the Almighty to go to Pharaoh. And at this time, when Allah told him, your request has been approved, Allah reminded him of many favors of the Almighty upon him at a time unknown to him. And each one of us can speak, you know, you're driving on the road and probably a car comes close by, just grazes you, or you are walking and somebody hurls a stone and you manage to avoid it. And the Prophet ﷺ said, مَا أَصَابَكْ لَمْ يَكُنْ لِيُخْطِئَكْ وَمَا أَخْطَاكْ لَمْ يَكُنْ لِيُصِيبَكْ. What avoided you wasn't meant to afflict you, and what afflict you wasn't meant to avoid you. And then you like lose your breath for a moment, and then you like, you just thank Allah that Allah saved you and rescued you. And absolutely Allah did that. There's no two ways about this. But we don't realize that when we were in the womb of our mom, there could have been so many complications during the period of pregnancy and birth. unknown to us, unaware how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made it easy and allowed for everything to follow in, in a relatively calm and easy way, as the Quran speaks about it. Thumma as-sabila yassara. Then Allah made the pathway easy for you to arrive on earth. So in verse 40 of Surah Taha, Allah tells Sayyidina Musa alayhi salam, إِذْ تَمْشِي أُخْتُكَ فَتَقُولُ هَلْ أَدُلُّكُمْ عَلَى مَنْ يَكْفُلُ. And remember the time when your sister was walking behind, and she stood there as a stranger, as a bystander, and then she observed the panic, the anxiety. So she said to the people, هَلْ أَدُلُّكُمْ عَلَى مَنْ يَكْفُلُ. Shame, I can see you very concerned about your child. Can I perhaps suggest to you a woman that I'm very much certain this child would drink the milk of that woman? And here in this book, the author takes it as fi hijri ummihi, in the lap of his mother. Wow, in the lap of his mother. So let's see the system of Allah. How does things unfold? Just to recap, he's there in the palace, Musa alayhi salatu wassalam.
وَأَصْبَحَ فُؤَادُ أُمِّ مُوسَى فَارِغًا إِنْ كَادَتْ لَتُبْدِي بِهِ لَوْلَا رَبَطْنَا عَلَىٰ قَلْبِهَا.
وَأَصْبَحَ فُؤَادُ أُمِّ مُوسَى فَارِغًا. And the heart of the heart of Musa alayhi salam's mom was restless. فَارِغًا عَمَّا سِوَى مُوسَى. She was in constant panic, anxiety, uneasiness. إِنْ كَادَتْ لَتُبْدِي بِهِ. She was on the verge of divulging it to people that basket in that is a baby is my child. لَوْلَا أَرَّبَطْنَا عَلَىٰ قَلْبِهَا. But we had strengthened her bosom and her heart and given her courage and strength, so that Allah and hence Allah made it easy for her. So وَقَالَتِ الْأُمُّ الْحَنُونُ لِأُخْتِ مُوسَى. And again, these things just speak out about the profound and selfless love of a mother. There's nothing in the world. There is simply nothing in the world. I mean, I've seen it with my venerable, honorable mom, and I've seen it with my beloved spouse, both the two women in my life. I've seen the kind of selfless display of love from my mom to myself and siblings. And I see the same love from my wife towards my children. You know what, night or day, morning or afternoon, hot or cold, they're just driven by the well-being of their children. And in regards to nursing, I mean, it's a sight that can make you cheer. But let's just move forward and then we'll discuss it as we get to that point. So the mother of Musa alayhi salatu wasalam says to the sister of Musa, and as I mentioned in the previous segment, her name was also Maryam. The sister of Musa alayhi salatu wasalam was also Maryam. اذهبي يا بنتي وانظري أخاك لعله حي. My daughter, go, just trail behind and just monitor from a distance and see what's the updates, and hopefully he's still alive. Of course, she is a mother and she has absolute love for her child. She has yaqeen and reliance on the promise of Allah that he will return. So she tells us the daughter to go and just trail him. إِنَّ اللَّهَ قَدْ وَعَدَنِي أَنَّهُ يَرُدُّ الطِّفْلَ إِلَيَّ وَأَنَّهُ يَحْفَظُهُ. It's the promise of Allah that Allah will return my son to me. So anyway, she goes and she comes there and she trails and she camouflages herself, as the Quran speaks about it in this verse, is تَمْشِي أُخْتُكَ. And also in the 20th juz, وَقَالَتْ لِأُخْتِهِ قُصِّي. وَقَالَتْ لِأُخْتِهِ قُصِّي. And the mother of Musa said to the sister of Musa, trail him, walk behind him. فَبَصُرَتْ بِهِ عَنْ جُنُوبٍ وَهُمْ لَا يَشْعُرُونَ. So she observed him as an onlooker, as a bystander, walking on the side, and they were unaware this was the sister of Musa alayhi salam. And she comes close up and she plays on and she observes people are stressed out. Oh man, yeah, the baby doesn't want to drink. Shame. We tried this one, we tried that one. We've exhausted all the wet nurses, but to no avail. And that's the verse of the Quran. At that time, the sister of Musa alayhi salatu wasalam made a proposal. And she said that, listen, wait, hang on. I do know of a woman. I'm pretty much certain that this child will latch on. So she was very wise, she was very intelligent, she was very calculated. She didn't say, this is my brother, and she didn't say, the woman I'm calling is his mother and my mother. She used generic expressions, right? When the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam and Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu were in the journey of Hijrah, now people knew about Nabi alayhi salam, but many of them had not seen Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam. So they heard that there is this prophet amongst the Arabs, and they heard that there's a price out to apprehend him sallallahu alayhi wasallam. So someone asked Abu Bakr on the journey, and I read in Al-Isaba fi Tamizis Sahaba and in other books as well, that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam took an alternate path from Mecca to Medina, not the common average, common route that people would travel on, so that the intelligence of the Meccans cannot apprehend him. So people asked Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, because they knew this was, who is this with you? So Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu said, huwa hadin yahdini, huwa hadin yahdini. He's my guide, he's guiding me. So people said, oh, okay. They assumed it to be a person showing the guide in terms of indicating the distance, the location, the navigation, the route, etc. While Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu referred to it as hadin, he is my guide to Jannah and Paradise. In Arabic, we refer to this as Tawriya. So the sister of Musa, Maryam, she offered, listen, I know of a woman, if you folks are interested, the child would latch on and the child would drink. So someone said, أنا لا أصدق. You know what? I don't believe you. قد جربنا ست مراضع ولكن الطفل لم يرتضع. We've tried 6 nurses and the child would not latch onto one. What makes you believe that the child will take onto this woman? 6 women of the best of kind, the best of milk, the best of health in every regard, and the child just refuses, blankly refuses. Why would the child specifically latch onto the woman you are suggesting? So another woman said, وَلِمَاذَا لَا نُجَرِّبُ السَّابِعَ مَاذَا عَلَيْنَا. Correct, point taken. The child refused 6. But what is there to lose in trying the 7th one? What is there? But this is all the plan of Allah. This is all the plan of Allah. You know, you said, I went there. And then they said, no, your documents cannot be processed because of this. And then luckily enough, just at that time, this man came and the previous person in charge moved away. And so he was more kind and he was more accommodating and he just approved everyone. We might think it's coincidence. We might think it's just apparent, but this is all part of the planning of the Almighty. كَذَلِكَ كِدْنَا لِيُوسُفْ. Thus did we plan for Yusuf alayhi salam. And in every regard, when Allah plans, in your favor, then everything fits in place. وَوَصَلَ الْخَبْرُ إِلَى الْمَلِكَ. The news reaches the queen. Asiya is informed about this here, that a young girl, just an observer, she's making a remark that she knows of a woman, and she's absolutely confident that the baby will latch on. فَطَلَبَتِ الْجَارِيَةَ وَقَالَتْ. She summons the young girl, unknown that this is the sister. لا إله إلا الله. لا إله إلا الله. So let's pause here again, my respected brother, sister, listener, viewer. So Pharaoh is now killing, and he killed and he massacred and he did everything. One is Allah allows for Musa to be born and to grow up, very discreetly, very silently, unknown to anyone. And that, of course, was a miracle, and none could deny that at the time that he ordered, yet a child grew up. But no, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allowed for Musa alayhi salam to be born and for him to reach the palace of Pharaoh and for Asiya, the queen, to arrange with his approval. And it gets more intriguing and riveting as we move on. So Asiya, the queen, says to Maryam, اذهبي وخذي معك هذه المرأة. I'm quite curious to know who this woman is. Wow, that sounds amazing. Do me a favor, young girl, please bring this woman along and come. La ilaha illallah, la ilaha illallah. وجاءت أم موسى وجاءت خادمة وقدمت إليها موسى. So here the mother of Musa alayhi salam comes to the palace of Pharaoh. She couldn't have imagined entering the palace of Fir'aun otherwise, not that she would have wanted to, But here she is given a royal reception and welcome because she is coming in the interest of our child. Hello, according to Pharaoh and Asiya, it's their child. But we know, and the tale is that Musa alayhi salatu wasalam's mum, she's obviously the biological mother of this child. But this is a very emotional, this is a very, very emotional moment. فَاعْتَنَقَتْ طِفْلُ الْمَرْأَةَ وَأَقْبَلَ يَرْتَضِعُ كَأَنَّهُ كَانَ مِنْهَا عَلَى مِعَادٍ. I just love these words. I just love these words. When the mother of Musa alayhi salam took Sayyidina Musa as a child and she latched him on, the way he latched on and the way he cuddled up, there wasn't a dry eye. It was as though there was an agreement between the two. I was waiting for you. I was waiting for you, mom. Now, you know what? Many of us, those that had children, and may Allah bless all those that are desirous of children, and those sisters that are desirous to have milk and nurse their children, may Allah make it easy. Sometimes women love to and wish to, but unfortunately, they don't have adequate supply of milk, etc. So may Allah make it easy for each one. However, I can attest to this from my own spouse and children, to see this bond between mom and child when the child latches on, and more so if the mom was busy in the shower or something and there was a bit of a gap and the child now is hungry and he or she needs a feed. And then when you latch that child on, that bond is just beyond description. It's going to move anyone to tears. It's going to move anyone. That is why when Allah described the intensity of Qiyamah, Allah said, يَوْمَ تَرَوْنَهَا تَذْهَلُ كُلُّ مُرْضِعَةٍ عَمَّا أَرْضَعَتْ وَتَضَعُ كُلُّ ذَاتِ حَمْلٍ حَمْلَهَا. That Qiyamah will be so severe that a nursing mother will abandon her nursing child. And in this human, the strongest bond between two is between a nursing mother and a nursing child. Often when it's the time of weaning the child off, which in Arabic we refer to as Fatima, one who has been weaned off. So the child goes through a bit of a cycle and becomes unwell, and so does the mother, because it's detaching. The child becomes independent. He or she now can move with the dad or the brother or the sibling or the uncle or the aunt. And for 2 long years, it was this amazing thing, and there's so much reward for a woman. وعلى الوالدات يرضعن أولادهن حولين كاملين لمن أراد أن يتم الرضاعة. And I urge and I implore my sister out there, if you are on the family way, devote the time and nurse your child. No science laboratory can produce the milk that Allah has created in your chest and your bosom for your child. You can express the milk, but you cannot transmit the motherhood. So when mom attaches to child, wow. Now you can imagine, this is 3 days have passed. The child's been floating. The child is extremely hungry. The child has declined every other nurse. Comes the mother of Musa. Comes the sister of Musa alayhi salam. Unknown to them, this is the mother and this is the sister. And as the mother latches on, I cannot imagine. Like I said, I've seen it with my spouse and the children when they were small, the bond, the emotions, the feelings, the love, and how they cuddle up to each other, That's it. You see it in the wild. How the little will feed on the mum and how the mum would care and protect her babies and her little ones. كَأَنَّهُ كَانَ مِنْهَا عَلَى مِعَادٍ. Like there was an agreement. Mom, where were you? I was waiting for you. وَلِمَاذَا لَا يَرْتَضِعْ وَهِيَ أُمُّهُ الْحَنُونَ. And why would the child not drink when this is the mother? And why would the child not drink when Allah had systematically and divinely barred any other woman from nursing him? This is a Nabi. This is a Nabi in the making. So Allah didn't want any other woman to nurse him. وَعَجِبَتِ الْمَلِكَةُ وَعَجِبَ أَهْلُ الْقَصْرِ وَارْتَابَ فِرْعَوْنَ. Now, as much as they were happy and relieved, it kind of activated some alarm bells. Wait, hang on, this sounds too good to be true. The child refused A, B, C, D, 1, 2, 3, 4. And as soon as this woman came, immediately the child latched on. Is she not perchance the mother of this child? قالت أم موسى يا سيدي أنا امرأة طيبة الريح طيبة اللبن كل طفل يقبلني. So the mother of Musa alayhi salam again used what we refer to as tawriya. Tawriya is an ambiguous, a vague expression. I'm a woman, you know what, my milk is pure, my nature is clean, my hygiene is absolute. So you can, you know, try any child, and any child and every child would accept and take to me, and I could latch any child on. So she didn't deny that she's the mother, nor did she divulge that she's the mother. وَسَكَتَ فِرْعَوْنُ وَأَجْرَى عَلَيْهَا رِزْقًا لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ. Pharaoh is silent because he doesn't want to probe too much. Why? Because the queen loves the child. The queen has said, there's no way we're going to harm this child. And now if we love this child, we want to adopt the child. And if we want to adopt the child, we need someone to nurse the child. Because the child refuses. What can you do? There's something. There's simply nothing you can do. There's simply nothing you can do. So he doesn't probe it anything more. He says, okay, that's fine. So the narration suggests that Musa alayhi salatu wasalam's mother says to Pharaoh and to Asiya, that listen, I need to get back home. I was just called in by this lady here, meaning her daughter, without divulging the profile. This is the system of Allah. This is the system of Allah. May Allah give us that inner conviction, that inner conviction. When Allah decrees a matter, it's just absolute. It's just absolute. Every bit and piece will fall into place. So I need to get back home. So they said, okay, well, if that's the case, we cannot compel you to be here. You can go home. And we will now pay you an allowance. We will pay you an allowance so that you can nurse our child. You can nurse our child. The jurists and the fuqaha have discussed this in great detail in terms of how did she accept remuneration and allowance and compensation for nursing her child, which was her natural duty as a mother. So there's difference of opinions given. In Durr Manthoor, there's a narration, mawquf and marfu', that in the previous Sharia, it was permissible to take that money in that context. And also many have given the argument that if she was to decline and not accept that remuneration and compensation, then that would create more sense of panic or alarm them even more. Well, if you or everybody else that came here wanted a handsome return, and you are prepared to nurse our child without taking any allowance, that probably makes it all the more definite that you are the mother. That makes it all more certain that you are nursing the child. So by taking the money from Pharaoh, which he had stipulated, still, you know, covered the whole thing, camouflaged it to an extent that they had the notion that it was their child. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala then says in this verse that we just recited, the 40th verse, فَرَجَعْنَاكَ إِلَىٰ أُمِّكَ فَرَجَعْنَاكَ إِلَىٰ أُمِّكَ. And O Musa, we returned you to your mother. You didn't know anything what was happening. Sometimes a mom will say, I gave birth. And then at that time, you know what? I had to be rushed emergency into theater. You were unwell. You were in an incubator for 3 months. And doctors had given up hope. And you don't know anything. Subsequent, when you grow up, you've been told about these things. فَرَجَعْنَاكَ إِلَىٰ أُمِّكَ. We returned you to your mom. كَيْ تَقَرَّ عَيْنُهَا وَلَا تَحْزَنَ. So that she can comfort her eye. She can comfort her eye. وَلَا تَحْزَنْ. And she does not grieve. And in the verse of the 20th juz, فَرَدَدْنَاهُ إِلَىٰ أُمِّهِ كَيْ تَقَرَّ عَيْنُهَا وَلَا تَحْزَنْ وَلِتَعْلَمَ أَنَّ وَعْدَ اللَّهِ حَقٍ. So that she can know with absolute certainty that the promise of Allah is an absolute reality. But majority of the people don't understand. We'll end it on this note. May Allah give us the conviction on the promises of Allah. Now, after this, Allah then highlights another special favor of the Almighty upon Musa alayhi salam. Wait for it in the following episode, what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminds him of his special favor on Musa alayhi salatu wasalam. May Allah grant us total reliance on all his promises. Wa sallallahumma wa sallim ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa ashabihi ajma'in. Walhamdulillahi rabbil alameen.